Climate change plays a significant role in public health on a global scale. Atenas Mena from Clean Air Now is sitting down with us to discuss how we can be better prepared. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
So talk to us about, you know, climate change and, you know, its impact really on public health.
Sure. So climate change is like this big monster that everyone just likes to toss and turn about. But honestly, climate change, when you think about it, it creates different severe weather impacts. It could increase vector-borne diseases. It increases heat impacts for our workers, for people who work outside. And then also when you think about like the air pollution that's currently going on because of fossil fuel industry and the lifestyle that we're living, climate change is only like being exacerbated even more from that.
It really has an impact on the public health system. Talk to me more about that.
Sure. So what we're seeing is because of like the vector-borne diseases, we're seeing diseases like earlier in the year. We're seeing diseases where they weren't really going on in the past. We're also seeing a lot of like respiratory problems, cardiovascular problems. That is something that with health, it's not always something that is asked about. You get asked, how are you eating? How are you working out? But are they asking you about how climate change is impacting your neighborhood, how air pollution or water quality could be impacting your health? And so that's something that now more and more is being seen as a question that needs to be asked and further explored to take care of our lives and our health.
And so talk to me about Clean Air Now and, you know, how are y'all really trying to make an impact?
Sure. So Clean Air Now is an environmental justice organization, and we're located in Kansas City, Kansas. It was actually started by community members, like actual residents that were starting to have symptoms and problems with their breathing. They were also noticing a lot of soot buildup around in their neighborhood, on their windows. And they were asking, does this impact my health? How is this going to impact my children? And they realized that they're right next to the second largest rail hub in the nation. They're right next to many industries, risk management plan facilities that are working with very toxic chemicals that can be cancer causing. And they're right next to highways, diesel trucks. So when you think about it, they have a surplus, right, of pollution being concentrated in one area. And that's what Clean Air Now is working toward, is toward advocating for everyone should have the right to clean air, water, and land. And how do we make those changes? Instead of just asking that community member, well, move. No, that's not the answer. What the answer lies is on better regulation, zoning practices, policies that could be put in place, and health providers can better understand how the environment impacts the health of their patients and how they can also play a pivotal role in making some of those greater systemic changes.
And so it's one of the reasons why you're here at the APHA annual meeting and expo to raise awareness about this. And talk to me about, you know, what y'all hope people will find out and learn as they're here.
Yeah, well, it's considered the number one health crisis of the world, and this is impacting not only people from outside of the United States, it's literally impacting specific zip codes that are throughout the U.S., that we have vulnerable populations like our children, the elderly, people who work outside, people with, like we mentioned, many different chronic diseases, and it's just another part of, like, the social determinants of health, right? So when we say social determinants of health, it means what in your environment, what are you being exposed to, and then also your education, the access to food, the access to good paying jobs to be able to work and make a living. We need to take all of those things into account to be a more holistic approach to how we provide healthcare.
So how can public health professionals really get involved and help you?
Since we're stationed in Kansas City, we work on local, state, and federal level policies. We try to work on civic engagement and the importance of how community members' voices need to be at decision-making tables. And what healthcare providers can do is reach out to Clean Air Now, attend some of our meetings, attend our events, meet us where the community is at, and better understand what are the concerns of the community. We've done door-to-door surveys with community. We've established a good trusting partnership with them. Work with us to see what research do we still need, what resources can we allocate, and then how can we advance and use your health expertise to advance some of those strong policies.
Well, thank you so much for being here, and thank you so much for talking to us about climate change.
Thank you so much for having me.